Good evening, Internet. I hope that you're doing well. I'm Lostwolfe, and we're going to play some Titan Quest. I'm going to get that all sorted out and started up real quickly. So you're going to hear it in the background. Oh boy. So we have that. Do we have Titan Quest? It looks like we do. Are you seeing Titan Quest? Yes, you are. Okay. All right. Here we go. Okay, so when last we spoke, I cleared out my inventory. The only thing that I didn't clear out was this, because we'd seen Raptor Tooth, I think, but I'm not sure. So this is 2% physical damage and 1+1 strength. I don't think I have anything else in my inventory. That is helpful, interesting. We were going to talk to this person here. I'm going to shut up and let them do some talking.
Our orders are to clear the wall, but these Peng aren't making it easy. A giant one has taken up by the guard tower over there. The men won't fight it. We'll just have to wait for reinforcements. It's bigger and stronger than 10 Peng. It picked up our captain and threw him into the woods. What good is a wall when you're fighting winged monsters? We thought our woes were over when the monster army passed through. Oh, we've been cursed with evil fates. The commander will be waiting for us on the other side. But what can we do? We don't dare go on. A giant Peng is blocking the way. We don't dare go on. A giant Peng is blocking the way.
Okay, so we got ourselves a side quest. And for the sequel, that's what we're doing as our main quest, Peng Problems. A group of soldiers sent to secure the Great Wall are held up because they dare not face a fearsome Peng that has landed on the wall. Help the soldiers defeat the Peng. We will get a magical weapon of some persuasion and experience. First of all, let's make some walls and get all that stuff started out. I'm not going to forget to heart oak this time. I wonder which way this Peng is. I don't believe, talked to any of these gentlemen. So I'm going to shut up and let the talking commence.
Hail, traveler! Before you lies the great wall that shields our land from barbarian hordes. It has never failed us before. But yesterday, before dawn, an army of beasts overran us and passed into the mainland. We have seen these beasts before, but not in such number. It was truly a terrible sight. We still struggle to clear the wall. Our watchmen say they saw a fearsome creature armed with a curved blade leading the army. The monstrous horde came upon us as if from nowhere. We were unprepared and lost many men. The worst of the monster plague had passed, we thought. But that was just the calm before the storm. We have not yet secured the wall. We have not yet secured the wall.
Well, I guess I know what we're going to call this episode. We need a second wolf. Wolf? There we go. And we also need our friend the Lich King. So, we have this over here, which we've hit, and that means we'll respawn there. Awkwardly in this game, as we've discovered, you can't go up ladders, so we won't be going that way. instead we'll be running along the wall. Now this, as far as I remember, is where I stopped playing. Like, I had been playing right up until this point. Got to the Great Wall, and then abruptly stopped. So we're completely and totally blind at this point. Or we're flying completely and totally blind, I should say. Bone pile, what have you? Watching my wolf friends a little more carefully. Oh, hang on. We have lost a wolf friend. We have lost all our friends. Whoa. You can stop following me now, it's fine. Oh my god. There we go. Let me try and take some of them. Oh good, okay. Either they lost interest, or some of them got killed. Oh boy, I see more of them. That is not good. Hey, Mr. Bonepile. Well, I wait for my other wolf to be available. Oh, okay. We killed some of them. Wow, okay, these guys evidently hit like a truck. Oh, that must be the Peng, actually. I think what I want to do, I'll have to get to safety before I do it, is I want to clear out his hench people. There we go, like that guy.
Not enough energy.
Oh my lord. I want to clear out his hench people, and then we will tackle him by ourselves. Assuming, of course, that he doesn't spawn more men in, which may be one of the problems we're dealing with here. I am not sure. Oh, this is the Peng. Okay. Now that he's by himself, it's a lot simpler. In case of killing him. Ta-da! Okay, let's head back. I don't think that was the guy that we were supposed to kill because it didn't update the side quest. Oh, there it did. Okay. Same problem. See, it's fine if you just beat back all the other guys that aren't the boss. Oh, goodness. I'm gonna shut up again so we can hear what he has to say.
You beat the giant Peng? It brushed off a dozen of our best men like flies. Well, I thank you, warrior. Please, bring word to the commander that we will soon have the wall cleared. Please, take me as your student. I wish to become as great a warrior as you are. Tell me, please, how did you defeat it?
Well, I ran away, and my wolves did most of the work.
Clearly, you are a great hero. Clearly, you are a great hero.
Thank you, I think. Okay, so, Bring word of their progress on the Peng's death to their commander further down the wall. Oh, so I didn't actually get the weapon. Aw. Ooh. That's okay. Let's see what the wall has to offer. A magic chest. I always worry, like, okay, so this is on a ledge, and so it's not likely to do this. But I always worry that it's going to occasionally spawn things over the edge. Ooh. 95 health. What have we got? This is technically better than the one that we have. Okay. Well, what we'll do is we will put this into slot 3 and I will retrieve, because we have over here a essence of the anchor Isis in there. We'll take that out and we'll slot it into the new ring. And we'll immediately more or less wear that. The regular Peng are just fine. Okay. Muster bone pile. Offer me something useful. And right there. Oh, my rats, I should heal this wolf. There we go. I'm watching my health bar in the corner of my eye, and every now and then when it flickers downwards like that, I keep thinking, oh god, I'm gonna get poisoned or something. Not that we've seen it happen in this playthrough, but there is always the possibility that things like that might start happening. Hey, it's our friend Tigerman. Thank you. Oh goodness, I recast my Lich King instead of healing him, which was what I was trying to do. There we go. Oh goodness, looks like someone is in need of our aid. There's the Shark Sea province. I like how he's just standing there casually while these guys battle it out. Is there anything to be had over here? Nope. He is just an edge of the wall. Okay, let's see what the commander has to say.
So, Si Chan's patrol is making progress. Excellent. I am glad to hear our men are handling things. Thank you for your aid, warrior. A mighty being came through here wielding a weapon of terrible destructive power. If I were you, I'd talk to the villagers in town. One of them may know where the beast went. For the time being, the village down below should be safe. A fearsome being did come this way, wielding a great curved blade. If I were you, I'd talk to some of the villagers in Jidan. It's not far. Some of them must have seen which way it went. Ask in Jidan village. Perhaps the people there saw where it went. Ask in Jidan village. Perhaps the people there saw where it went.
Okay, so we got this. This is a chilling contest of agility. 46 to 63 damage, which is okay. 30% pierce ratio, which is also okay. 2 to 5 cold damage. Weh. Wow. Let's put this here. And then we'll have a 3-slot area there to put stuff in. I wonder, he was talking about a village. And I am gonna, oh, there we go. I am gonna guess that the village isn't that far away. Except first, people. Oh, hang on. There's a dude here with range. There are lots of dudes with range. Ow. Where am I? Oh, I was gonna say. My wolves must have gotten all entangled in killing someone. But nope, they were all just bunched up together with my friend the Lich King. And so I couldn't see them. Okay, oh. Hello. Oh. Are these guys fighting amongst themselves? Oh, whoa, hang on, hold on. Problem. Crisis. Okay. Crisis narrowly averted. Oh hey, it's a little camp. You, with the shooty shooties. You need to die. Because as we've discovered, range of the bane of my existence. I'm just going to go around the outside for right now. And then eventually, we will head on into the inside of the map. Oh, this guy is an important guy. And see what there is to see. Where you? Oh, there you are. Oh boy. That guy seems a little bigger than everyone else. It seems to me like all my regeneration isn't actually keeping pace with the damage output. Which is a little bit frustrating, because that was one of the things I was going out of my way to sort of make sure that I had solved by picking up all the regeneration items I could. Oh well. Oh boy, okay. See if we can get this pack leader by himself. There we go. Generally getting folks by themselves helps a lot. Ooh. Okay, in formula, Book of Dreams. Sleep duration is good. Okay, what do I need? A whole bunch of stuff. That I don't think we're ever gonna get to. This is the seal of acuity. It's a little silly. Let's put that note over here. We don't sell it. Uh-oh. Whoa. Hang on. Oh, boy. Oh, he stunned me, but my wolves got there. My wolves are my best friends, basically. Okay, so I'm pretty sure that... Oh, we actually managed to get everything. Right. I am amused and surprised. It looks kind of like you can go down there, but you obviously can't. I want that, thank you. And then we're just gonna zip across here. Aha, here's the village. Now, I expect that there are gonna be a handful of quests here. Oh, wow. That gives me a very Mr. Pandaria sort of feeling. I like it. I am, I guess, in the minority in that I actually liked Mr. Pandaria. Because I like the idea of the pandas. And I love the design. And the weather systems that they had going. One of the very best things was to end up in the Valley of the Four Winds. And then to have a thunderstorm happen along. That was one of my favorite things. It was just peaceful. I'm obviously not understanding how this village is built because I'm not getting any further into it. Architecture, how does it work? Oh, there's that, no? Hold on, let's look at the map real quickly. Oh, there's a side path, or main path, that's much bigger and leads downward. It doesn't look like it. What? Oh, there we go. Okay. There's a quest giver. There's some random people. There's another quest giver. I was thinking that there'd be a whole lot of quests here. That's out, I guess. Turn on that. That's also out, I guess. Oh, no. That is our next warp spot. I see a handful of people to talk to. Okay, so let's start by talking to the people that aren't going to give us quests. Okay, I like this area. Of the little villages and things that we've seen so far, I think this may be my favorite. Right, I'm going to shut up and these guys are going to talk.
Ah, a guest to our village. Lately, we've only had the rude kind. I mean the monsters. My sons have gone east to Luoyang. I long so much to see their faces. But I hope they stay there where it's safer. Ha! The army! They'll defend the wall. But look! Monsters are here! Here on this side! Well, will they defend all of us? No, they can't, can they? Yes, the monsters were here before. Now more come, so peace and harmony will stay far from our land. A peasant. He fears to walk the roads these days. But you, by your looks, it's the monsters that tremble. Am I right? A good day to you. A good day to you.
And a good day to you too. I didn't see anyone. No, I did not. Here we go.
When Sun Wukong, the Monkey King, was invited up to the heavens, it was trouble. The Monkey King was stubborn, strong, and clever. Sun Wukong knew all kinds of magic. He could jump 800 miles in a single leap, and he had a staff that changed size at will. When the Jade Emperor, ruler of the Immortals, invited the Monkey King, they thought he might behave. Maybe he would have. But sadly for them, they did not invite Wukong to the royal banquet. To spite their rudeness, he was later found eating all the peaches of immortality from the Emperor's tree. And he did many other wicked things besides. Then there was trouble. After he defeated the Army of the Heavens single-handedly and caused much other trouble, the Immortals finally caught Sun Wukong. They trapped him under a mountain, a whole mountain, and there he's still stuck today. I didn't see it happen, and you didn't either. Some say earthquakes happen when Sun Wukong struggles against his bonds.
That line where he said, I didn't see it and you didn't see it either, they just lopped off the first bit, which was, that's the story they tell.
I didn't see it happen and you didn't either. Some say earthquakes happen when Sun Wukong struggles against his bonds.
Okay. So we have two quests. We're going to grab both of them. One is up here. I think I saw two quests.
We saw this Telkin you speak of. It carried a great sickle, and those cursed beasts thronged around it. We watched it come from the Great War and disappear into the Jingyong Woods in the direction of Chong'on. You could see the great sickle from far off, held aloft like a beacon, like a weapon. There are rumors that the Emperor already left the Chong'on Palace, and that monsters have broken down the walls. Who can say what is true? The road beyond our gates leads through Jingyang Woods to Chang'an, the Imperial City. The road beyond our gates leads through Jingyang Woods to Chang'an, the Imperial City.
Okay, he helped us by moving our quest a little bit. The Tolkien was headed towards an eastern city named Jingyang. His purpose unknown. Okay, let's see what else we have here. There's another quest giver.
If you are taking the road to Chang'an, do not stray into the forest. I have heard a terrible beast wanders there. They say this beast is a monstrous man spider, ancient and deadly. It preys on weary travelers who stray from the roads. There is another old myth that this forest beast was once no more than a simple spider, until it swallowed some item of great magic, which transformed it and gave it strength. Believe me, if you value your life, stay on the path in the Jingyang Woods. The Jingyang Woods are dark and dangerous. Best to pass through them quickly. The Jingyang Woods are dark and dangerous. Best to pass through them quickly.
And they're especially so at night, which is why we're not going to do that at night. Or we're going to try not to anyway, so I have...
See what we have to offer.
A whole pile of stuff here that I wanted to sell. Is this ring? This is not a useful ring. Okay. I saw a lot of guys. But I do not believe. And I'm just going to do one last pass around here. I don't believe I saw someone who could take items apart. Storage? Well, no, that's not storage, I lie. Okay, so no. Alright. Let's add the portal. Portal, where are you? There you are. And where? I think there was one in the Western Soul Code. Ah, yes, here we go. This was a village with all the amenities. Where's our friend? Mr. Lightning Bolt. I'm pretty sure you were here somewhere. Let's not hit that. What? Okay, I guess I was wrong. I could have sworn there was a dismantler here. Well, I mean, I don't mind going backward a bit. It looks like we may have to do that. Hold on, yeah. Let's go to Egypt, and we know that there was a guy in Memphis. That's, I haven't showed this off yet, but that's a good thing, by the way, that the game actually lets you go back to previous acts. If you wanted to dig up, like, relics and essences and things, you could. Now I have to remember where this guy is. I think he is over here. He was in, if I recall, oh god. Yeah, tell you what, I'll just put this nonsense out. There we go. There we go. Okay.
Formula.
So we have this ring over here, and we would like to separate it. We want the relic. Grab our relic.
So long.
I'm going to stick this on to this particular ring and wear that. For a minute there, I wasn't actually watching what I was doing, and I was terrified I broke the wrong ring. Oh, while we're here, and as I know where Storage Man is, let's put away some of our stuff. Because we don't need the letter. And I don't believe that we have, or I'm sure we might have.
Storage for the burdened traveler!
Aha, we have some raptor tooth. Listen to here. That's interesting. These are all red. And this is blue. I wonder if that makes this better. Oh, it's a greater artifact. There we go. These are lesser artifacts. This is a greater artifact. That goes a long way to explaining that.
Your goods are safe with me. I can hold that for you. Safe travels.
And back we go. Now, I'm not sure. It looked to me like there were two doors. Two ways out of the village. And I don't think they're going to end us in the same spot. Ultimately. I think. Okay. I was almost convinced that we'd be able to go down here. But the only way to go is this way. So they're all going to lead to the same spot. The Jin Yang Woods. Which we're doing by night. Which which was one of those things. Oh, it's also funny and interesting to notice that we swapped areas and it was still night, because the game has its own built-in internal clock. And regardless of how far you travel, and even if you're doing it over long distances and you're doing it through teleportation, it's still night according to the game. Which I find sort of funny, I guess. That's terrible, but thank you. Oh. I was thinking that was going to be a little side path, and then it wasn't. Just an area we could explore. That's okay. Oh, we'll steal the raptor tooth. Hey, I think we can actually make a raptor tooth now, because we have all of them. That's terrible. Where's the path? There we go. Excellent. I like how I'm just running around trying to fill in the map, and my guys are doing all the heavy lifting. I wonder if secretly, like, you know, when they're alone with each other, the wolves and Lich King, they don't all point and laugh and go, "What is that man doing? Why is he leading us?" I mean, they certainly didn't sign up for this. I signed them up by summoning them. Daylight. One of the things I do appreciate is that given the way this game is set up with its isometric view, and given that you can't actually change the camera at all, I appreciate that when daylight happens. Normally I'd be more in favor of slower daylight, like as in the sun rising slowly and creating beautiful sunrises and sunsets and all that. But I'm grateful that this particular game doesn't actually spend all that time doing that. It's just like, here's daylight, shazam. And I'm grateful to that mostly because of the angle at which the game is played. Because part of the problem, of course, is that night is really night. And if you guys are having trouble seeing it, then just know that I am too. There's almost no point in putting up the brightness for this, because the nights are just too short for that. It's not like, my favorite game that had like a night area, and it wasn't really a night area, it was just a light switch. There was a game called Bureau 13, like a billion years ago, which was, by all accounts, like, not a good game, right? So let's just set the scene right there. It wasn't a good game. And at one point in Bureau 13, you walk into a room and the lights are turned off, right? Now, in most games, that's fine. But Bureau 13 wasn't a good game. So not only were the lights out, it went one step further. It made it so you couldn't see the interface at all. And I want to say that you could see your cursor, And that was like it. That was the only thing you could see on the screen. And it was just, it was terrible. And kind of funny. I mean, the first time I ran into that situation with that game, I just laughed. Because of how kind of grossly incompetent and stupid it was. I mean, those guys were trying hard, obviously. They probably poured a lot of money and their hearts and souls into that game. Because Burrow 13, the thing about it is that it is a... That game was an adaptation of a pen and paper game by the same name. And so obviously these guys... had a license. And they were just, you know, they were trying to make ends meet, basically. And they turned in a game that was just kind of okay. And I feel sorry for developers in that situation. Like, what do? You get saddled with this thing. And maybe, like I say, their hearts and souls were in the game. And they wanted to make the best product possible. But they didn't have the resources, or they didn't have the time. And so things like, night falls, and it falls in a very crazy way. Oh, there we go. Side quest. I actually can't see what's going on with all the loot on the ground. And the angle of the sun. Let's head back and turn in our quest. So I don't forget. That's a thing that I really appreciate, you know, when someone's in a situation like that and they're trying really hard despite all the obstacles. Does this guy have something new to say about the situation?
Ah, a guest to our village. Lately, we've only had the...
No. Where is... Yeah. We're standing by the cart. There we go. Where are you, Mr. Questgiver? Oh, my lord. On the plus side, by the time I get going here again, it's going to be properly day. And it's going to be much easier to run around. Oh, there we go.
These are dangerous times, aren't they, warrior? Most of us dare not travel, even when we have great cause. But one like you, you travel freely. You see, there is a thing of great value. It rests in a cave deep in the Jingyong Forest. Although it is quite valuable, I would offer far more than it's worth. You see, that is how much I desire it. This trinket is deep in the cave. Surely monsters have swarmed there, but I think I have gold enough to make it worth the trouble. This trinket is deep in the cave. Surely monsters have swarmed there, but...
That's the first time we've seen a quest actually do that, where it ends one quest and directly starts another one.
Fine blades, any warrior would want.
I really should put these things in a safe spot before I do something dumb and sell them. He was telling us about the quests. So we were stalking in the woods, which we finished. A giant beast walked deep in the Jinyang woods. It will trouble lost travelers no more. And we have the wealthy collector. There is a wealthy man in Zedang village named Le Boe. I am sorry if you're Chinese and you're listening to this and I'm making the names all terrible. He seems to be interested in any able traveler. He mentioned that he greatly desires a valuable item buried deep in a cave in Jinyang Woods, and that he would pay handsomely for it. Find the item and bring it to him. He's going to give us a powerful ring. Now, we, when I was in the woods, I didn't look to see if there was a cave. And, like, just judging from the layout of the caves and everything, I was almost willing to bet money that there was going to be something like a cave in here. It seemed too convenient for there not to be. The question is, I want to almost say, the cave is going to wind up being over here in actual woods. Where am I? I'm over here. It's interesting to me and cool too that they've captured in this isometric view the feel of a woods, you know, with the trees and not being able to see where you're going and the kind of claustrophobic feeling of a woods. They've done that really well. Like from this angle, you'd have to do a lot of good work to get it to the point where, you know, people would think it would be claustrophobic, but there we go, they've done it. Pretty good. There's lots of little tiny things about Titan Quest that, as a second time player, I am grateful that I am getting to see. These guys are blending into the forest because they're the same color. It's ridiculous. Oh, goodness. Okay, so, a frostbite shrine we never noticed. Oh, didn't realize that the Lich King died. But of course he did. Okay, so where was it here? Now let's see if we can find that entrance, the cave entrance that they're talking about. And then we're gonna start going on a break. We are almost at break time. Although I don't necessarily think we're just gonna automagically run into the caves. Maybe a bit of a hide and seek thing where the caves are where I least expect them. In fact, I think it behooves me to run along the very edge here. I can see. Because I'm gonna imagine that if there is a cave, it's right along the rocky edges of this sort of foresty area here. and not inside it. Like, I almost would have put it over here if I were designing this level. Ooh. Oh, Lich King, you have a propensity for death. I mean, I guess that's your whole thing. You are a agent of death. But this is ridiculous, man. Okay. It's probably going to be across the road. So, grab you and you. Oh, guy that we didn't actually loot. Then I'm gonna just head in here, pull out the gap for the map, and we're going to go on a break. It is time. Wow. yeah, that's about it. Probably a couple of guys here. And we have the bone pile, which is currently giving us nothing at all. Let's head to the bridge. Right, when I get to the bridge, we're going to call a 10-minute break. If you want to go get something to eat or drink, please feel free to do that. I'm going to do the same, and I hope to see you soon. Have a wonderful break, folks. Goodbye for now. Okay. Welcome back, folks. I hope you have your drink of choice. I had some water. And I'm ready to proceed. With some amount of caution. During the break, I was trying to think of other games like My Friend Bureau 13 that had, like, poor life choices with regards to design and that kind of thing. I couldn't think of, like, modern ones that I had played. I can think of some old games that didn't have bad life choices so much as they had design constraints. Like, when you think about text parser games and all that kind of thing, they didn't really have a choice about the way they were designing. And they were designing basically for the hardware and the limitations that hardware had. And usually the limitations were basically that no one had thought to make video cards yet. Whenever that happens, whenever someone does a spell like that, jumps in an area like that, I get terrified. Usually I think that the actual act of the sweeping arc is what's going to kill me. Oh. Look at this. Uh-oh, hold on. Problem. I ain't gonna have to pick up more stun resist. If there's anything in this game that I'm slowly learning, it's that stun resistance, and probably eventually sleep and so on, are going to become ever more important. There are a lot of spiders and things about. And that just means webs and stuns and nonsense like that. Okay, so we've seen outside. Oh, I think we've seen all this little island. Aha, there we are, cave entrance. That was what we're after. And I thought there'd be something there because there were all of the spiders and it looked like there was a path and there we go, perfect. If you're wondering why it's being so quiet there, it's because I just wanted to soak in the beautiful music that this game has to offer. I love all the little themes that play from time to time. It's just a well put together soundtrack. There's nothing, I mean, I haven't heard anything here that I would remember. If unfortunately, and I think that's kind of a problem of modern game design. Modern game design has to make games that, or has to make soundtracks that all sort of blend into one, because the unique sound chips that we have are gone now. So everyone's trying to use orchestras and trying to use, you know, synthesizers and all that sort of thing. Real world instruments to make game music. And while sometimes that can be good, I also feel like sometimes it can be, it's not necessarily in keeping with how games feel or sound. And so I think gaming as a whole is sort of doing itself a disservice by not playing it to its sort of unique strength. Oh, hello. Didn't notice you there.
Why did you save me? I have no wish to live. I hoped only to die nobly. Forgive me. These are dark times for our land. When you have lost as much as I have, it is easy to lose hope. But you... You, warrior, you fought those monsters as if hope still exists. I fear I may have been in error. Every village I did not protect. I see it now. I was wrong. The only noble actions are selfless ones. Protecting the weak and innocent from chaos and malice. Yes, I see this now. Warrior, your example has taught me wisdom. I will protect our people to my last breath. Warrior, your example has taught me wisdom. I will protect our people to my last breath.
Okay, so we had a lesson in despair. I'm going to read a wealthy collector in a minute because I think we tracked down... Oh, okay, it didn't actually ping. A proud warrior was standing in the woods, fighting bravely, but completely without hope. He seemed to want to die. After talking with him, he seemed to take heart and overcome his despair. He began to see that the warrior is bound by duty to protect the defenseless. By saving the innocent, well, the warrior makes hope where there was none. That's actually really cool. We got a pile of experience for that. I was just watching the yellow bar going, ooh, goodness. By rights, I should have just zinged back. Yeah, well, you know what, actually, hold on, let's do that. Let's get to the other bridge and then just zip back. With a town portal. Because otherwise all this running back and forth is silly. That's a thing that I want to talk about at some point. I am ambivalent when it comes to fast travel. Sometimes I like it and it makes sense. Sometimes I do want to see the world and take it in and travel the way the world would want me to travel. Not just zip from place to place. And maybe not this game, because this game doesn't encourage that. Maybe in one of the other games that we play, we will not use fast travel. We'll just... really? Oh. Did I not? I thought I turned that on. I am pretty sure I turned that on. Oh no, I did not. Sorry. I thought that this... This has called itself the Great War Village. Which is confusing because it shouldn't be named like that. Where is... It should be named the actual village name that it was. Where's this guy? He's up here, right? Yeah. Hear what he has to say.
Ah, excellent. I am good to my word. Here is your payment. I hope you find it satisfactory. Because there are monsters, should living stop? Should all business end? Some say so, but I say it is folly. Fortune has smiled on me. I have some wealth. I like to collect rare things of value. Thank you, warrior. Your help has been most appreciated. Good day, traveler. Fortune and prosperity come to you. Good day, traveler. Fortune and prosperity come to you.
So I don't think it's going to turn out this way. But much like with a priest back in Egypt, this guy just gives me scary, scary vibes. He just makes me worried. So, actually, let's just read his quest text. There was a wealthy man in Zidane Village. See, I thought that this would be named Zidane Village on a portal list. He said he would pay handsomely for it. Luba Wei proved true to his word. I'm stumbling over that because it's ridiculous. He gave us a small ring of endowment, which looks like this. It's 2-6 fire damage and 38 offensive ability. Not too fussed about it. Let's instantly sell all this nonsense. We're dragging around with us. Where's a salesman? Salesman. Come to my aid. And take these things off of me. Thank you.
Goodbye then.
Goodness. So when I was seeing this over here, and it's a Chang'an, I was a little puzzled and confused. Because I thought that I was looking for a village name, not the Great Wall. And I actually thought that the Great Wall was going to teleport me somewhere closer to the actual wall, not the village. It looks almost like you should be able to walk in the swamp, but I guess not. Yeah, well, that's okay. Yeah, you see here, looks like we should be able to walk in the swamp. Oh, that actually reminds me of another sort of semi-terrible game that I was talking about this whole design thing earlier. Where people were just working with the constraints of the hardware that they had. It was a Square Enix RPG, no less, called Eternal Ring. And Eternal Ring has a spot where you can walk into the water and drown. How to get pets in this game? I still couldn't find out. Hello! Gamu. I'm going to call you Gamu because I'm going to mispronounce your name otherwise. So let me show you what I've done. So I'm in heavily in nature, right? And in nature, right at the bottom here, there's wolves that you can get. That's Call of the Wild. Call of the Wild lets you get two wolves, and under certain circumstances, there's stones in the world called mastery shrines. If you have 16, like I have up here, I have 16 of 16 in the wolf tree. If you get 16, and you hit a mastery shrine, you'll get to 20, and then you'll be able to summon a third wolf. No problem. It's a fun game. If you haven't played it, I advise playing it. It's a blast. The other pet that I'm running, who is now dead, is the Lich King. And I'll actually show you that too quickly, once I get out of combat. Just a second. You can take two masteries, right? I have nature mastery here, I have spirit mastery. And in spirit mastery, if you get to level 10, you get access to the Lich King, who is another pet that you can have. But most of the reasonable pets are all in the nature tree. So if that's what you're looking for, then that is sort of what you want to do. No problem, by the way. Always glad to help. Thank you for stopping by and having a look at the stream. Sorry, I was talking about Eternal Ring. And so the goofy thing about Eternal Ring is it's an old PlayStation era game. Of course, because it's an old PlayStation era game, there were just some things that they didn't really want to mess with. One of those, I guess, in that game was they didn't want to mess with swimming too much. So anytime you got into water, like It could be a tiny puddle. It could be a great big ocean. You just instantly drown. Which again, I guess, was just a limitation of the era. There was a bridge that I saw. There we go. Oh, wolves, what have you discovered? This is Shaanxi Fields. I feel like that's not right. Surely. Well, maybe. Maybe it is right. Ooh. And we have night that is falling. I don't mind the woods, but I don't think they're going to be very conducive to seeing what's going on if we're in them at night. I did. Someone stunned me again. We really are going to have to get anti-stun stuff. That's okay. I have a feeling. Yeah, this is a camp. Shouldn't really be opening that. I should be killing all the people first. There we go. Camp. Hooray. I really should be making a point of clearing out the camp before I click on the boxes. But on the other hand, I don't really want to forget about the boxes, so it makes a certain amount of sense to just see what's in them as soon as I get there. There ain't anything here, right? Nope. Just teeny tiny walkways. Oh. That's probably forward. Oh, they have a whole little village here with like cops and things that they're going and everything. I feel sort of bad that I'm killing them. On the other hand, they are attacking me when I approach, so that's because I'm raiding their village. Ah, goodness. I think. Oh. Oh, no. Well, it was just a regeneration shrine, thank goodness. That could have gone very, very badly. What do we have here? Not much of anything. That's one of the things I do kind of miss is we were talking about old games earlier, and generally those old games wouldn't let you necessarily just teleported wall. If you look as far back as for this particular game, the ancestor of this is Diablo 2, and Diablo 2 had time portal scrolls, which you had to hoard pretty much. And that encouraged seeing the world. It had problems, obviously. Acadian Wampa. 10% chance of 24% energy drain. Ooh, that's quite good. And 2% second, 2 seconds of stun. 5 to 11 cold damage. This is a version of an Acadian Thromper. This one is a little bit better than what we have. We will just wear it. Yeah, we'll just wear it. I mean, it's got slightly better stats. We may as well, right? As far as I can tell, I'm not missing anything. Gangs, outskirts, and a quest. I wonder if that's... Oh, no, it's not. Okay, that's a new quest. Uh-oh. Perhaps I should have taken a quest before I went down here. Although I don't think it would necessarily just say clear out these guys as a quest this late in the game. Ooh. Retrieve Trigular. 5% chance of 16% reduction of the enemy's health. 3% 3 seconds of skill disruption. That's not too bad. And 29 offensive ability. It's worse than what we have though, so... That is soul material.
Warrior! Listen to me. A woman asked me to look out for one like you. She waits in the center of the city. This city, Chang'an. But have you heard the news? Chaos runs wild in the streets. The great emperor's terracotta soldiers have come to life. They have left the mausoleum and are terrorizing the city. I don't know who the woman was, but clearly she knew of your coming. They say the Lord of the Beasts entered our land recently. They say he came holding a great gleaming sickle. How can clay soldiers come to life? Some powerful magic is being used. I am sure of it. The woman asked if I had seen a foreign warrior and gave me gold to watch for you. Go into the city. She waits for you. She waits for you in the city. Go now and find her. She waits for you in the city. Go now and find her.
That pinged the main quest. The Tolkien was headed towards an eastern city named Chang'an. His purpose unknown. So far, a woman in Chang'an is looking for you. That can only be the woman that we met in the last chapter, right at the end, where she was frustrated that they were sending you, not her. And we heard about the terracotta soldiers. The terracotta soldiers are somewhat famous in history. They were like a magical army that would come to life in times of great strife. And they would defeat those enemy invaders. Oh boy, I died. I don't remember where the last... Oh wow. That was some ways away, wasn't it? No, it wasn't too bad. Yeah, it wasn't too bad. Could have been worse. There always has to be a death. Where are we headed? Oh, okay, yeah, it's not too bad. Could have been infinitely worse. Let's try it again. Mainly that happened because I did it again, let myself get surrounded. There we go. See? Not letting yourself get surrounded helps a lot. Seems like a dead end, yeah. I just want to look at the map. I don't think that's Rhinothorns. Well, I mean, we passed by it. So, it ain't going to be useful now. I also don't think necessarily this is... Nope, this is not the way to the center of the city. I was entirely correct. Just a side street. Oh. This is a lot of nonsense. I'd like to get out of there. I'd like... So that wasn't so much getting surrounded as it was getting stunned. Oh. Where's... Oh, right. The only problem with this is we are losing experience when we do this. So we need to learn to not do this. Or I need to learn to direct my attacks a little better and to stay back a bit for this particular set of fights. That's really the lesson that I should be taking away here. These guys. There. I'll grab you guys. Oh man. I was trying to keep the Lich King alive and he died. Oh, hang on. Problem. Oh, you know what these guys are doing? They're putting down banners. That's a battle standard, and a battle standard makes them stronger. And that is a bit of a problem. I'll have to be a little bit wary of these streets. Yeah, I'll have to back away here. There's this guy. There was another guy. Oh, okay, he's dead. Good. Gonna have to be a little bit more mindful than I usually am. I'm just running in willy-nilly and trying to get things killed and... Obviously, that ain't working. Uh-oh. Let's just clear out these guys on the outskirts here. Head back in and talk to the people and see what there is to see. We got this guy here. Grimhooked Blade of Feasting. 31-35 damage. 16% life leech. That's very good. Dexterity is through the roof though. Yep. 11 vitality damage. 8 vitality damage. 8% attack damage converted to health. I really want to keep this. But I don't ever think we're going to get to the vitality amount that we need to use a dexterity amount.
We are working hard.
take back Chang'an. But we have more problems than just the monsters. Somehow the great emperor's clay soldiers have come to life. The mausoleum where they were buried is overrun. There was no warning. Suddenly the terracotta soldiers came pouring through the mausoleum door, swords drawn. It is a terrible development. The monsters were giving us enough trouble. There was a legend that the soldiers would come to life in our time of need to defend us. Now they attack us instead. Something terrible has happened here.
There we go. He was mentioning what I was saying, that the terracotta soldiers basically would come to life when there was trouble and they'd beat back the enemy. But here they are beating up on the townspeople, which is not good.
It is safe here. Watch yourself past the guards and stay clear of the mausoleum. It is safe here. Watch yourself past the guards and stay clear of the mausoleum.
The terracotta soldiers aren't worse than the monsters. No, the problem is our guards fear them. They think somehow it's the spirit of the great emperor. Nonsense. I guess I shouldn't blame them. These times would make even a wise man superstitious. Yes, the men are afraid. They think anyone who kills one of these clay men will be cursed. But we can't secure the city until they're destroyed. I've offered a reward to anyone who'll fight them, but nobody's stepping forward. I've offered a reward to anyone who'll fight them.
Well,
nobody's stepping forward.
That's where we come in. Okay, so we have over here the Emperor's Clay Soldiers, Terracottas at Large. These things are two tied together quests, I guess. In the mausoleum of the great emperor, the army of terracotta soldiers have come to life. They're wreaking havoc in the city of Chang'an. Enter the mausoleum and put a stop to the chaos. You get a powerful amulet for that, a lot of experience and two attribute points. That's good. Terracotta at large. Many terracotta soldiers are loose in the city. The guards are superstitious and won't go near them, so they cannot secure the rest of the city. Defeat these clay soldiers throughout Chang'an. We get a magical weapon and some experience. Of course. Hello there, sir. I forgot to pick up my grave for experience. That was back, right? I believe I did. Oh, no, I didn't. You're right. Thank you. Thank you very much for that. I was so intent on getting through there and staying alive that I did, in fact, forget about my grave. I appreciate that you mentioned it. Okay, so I saw the hooked blade of acuity up here, which I want to grab through the doors. I think we want to head this way first, because I saw another quest. Right, let's see what I have to say.
Champion, I only just arrived by boat, back in my own land once again. Word has spread that you have traveled the whole length of the Silk Road, pursuing the Talking. The Talking arrived in this city not long ago, but now seems to have mysteriously vanished. Many of our order are out looking for him, but he has yet to be found. Our scholars have been studying our most ancient scrolls to find out why the Talking came here. It seems that the last Titan defeated in the Great War was not banished by the gods with his brethren, but was imprisoned here on Earth. And the texts say he is here in this region. Our greatest fear is that the Talking has come to free him. If we are to have any chance of stopping the Talking, you must journey to the mystical Jade Palace and speak with the Yellow Emperor. If he can be found, he will know the whereabouts of this Titan. Our scholars found passages of an epic poem that describe the Jade Palace as being on a white mountain. They believe the white mountain is Mount Shiyun, located to the west beyond the Jinghe Valley. It is said only the most worthy may visit the palace. Good luck.
Hello there, Swazir King. Swazir King? Yes, Swazir King. I am from Earth. I'm really live in Titan Quest, yes, and it's, I'm enjoying it immensely. I played it probably when it came out, so 2006, and I got up to the Great Wall, and then something shiny came along, and I stopped playing it, and now I'm going to try and finish it, because it's a fun game, and I'm enjoying it very much. Oh, yeah. Zerking, yes, indeed. I'm from Earth. I'm not inclined to say where I'm from. I'm not happy with that particular question. But here we go. I want to listen to what this woman has to say. Oh, you played it for 10 years and you just love it. Yeah, it is fun. I'm glad that I picked it up now. And I'm glad that they're still working on it because it's turned out to be a great experience. You're from Sweden. Yeah, I figured so. I hope Sweden is doing well tonight and you're having a good time there. Right, let's hear what this woman has to say.
Emperor Huang Ti, the Yellow Emperor, was a great Chinese hero and scholar. After performing many great deeds, he went to live in his Jade Palace, which we think is high on Xi Yun Mountain, across the Jinghe Valley. There, he long contemplated life and found the secret to immortality. Since then, he has spent his endless days in contemplation of the nature of the universe. It is said that he made his wisdom like his palace, available for all who are worthy to find it.
I'm enjoying nature a lot. Nature's great because it means that I can just set my guys on whoever and then just watch the carnage happen.
I wish I could help you with this task. But I realize I cannot. My quest has become yours. It is up to you now, and there is no one I would trust more. If we are right, you must move quickly and find the Yellow Emperor in his palace atop Xi Yun Mountain. Good luck. If we are right, you must move quickly and find the Yellow Emperor in his palace atop Xi Yun Mountain. Good luck.
You don't have to donate. I appreciate just playing the game for you. I'm happy to do that. And I tend to run all my endeavors like that. I'm just happy to share these games with people who are happy to be, you know, having a good time and a laid-back time. And just enjoying the game. Yeah, that's about it. That's the sum of it. I want us to have just a laid-back good time. Okay, so we have a quest here. In Act 3, which obviously picks up from the main quest. So we got Journey to the Jade Palace. Brian claims the Yellow Emperor may know where the Tolkien went. Legend states that the Emperor lives in a Jade Palace at the top of Mount Crean. Few mortals have been admitted to the palace. Travel to the Jade Palace and speak to the Yellow Emperor. I love international Mr. English. That's good. okay, so what have we got here? I see a fountain which we need to wake up. And some doors and things. I should probably actually wander the city very quickly and just see if there are services. There are. That's good. I think we should empty out our inventory. And there are a couple of people we can talk to as well. I think we are going to do that. Yeah, let's talk to these people real quickly and hear what they have to say.
The great master Confucius taught us that ritual and virtue would perfect the world. But what good are they when rough beasts burn our houses and storm our walls? It is said our highest aim is to create virtue and harmony throughout the world, but such thoughts seem like a baby bird trapped in a raptor's jaws. You are a true warrior, I can see. We all should have studied the ways of war. In the end, maybe that is the only wisdom. Rites and music is what Confucius taught, meaning order and harmony. One is our duty, the other our reward. All my life I have studied and tried hard to observe my duties. What if all of it is swept away, like the wind sweeps fog from the river's edge? There's little hope in these times, yet we still must live by virtue. There's little hope in these times.
There was another guy over here that I wanted to talk to real quickly.
These are terrible times. Times of great woe to the living. And so it is we should hear about Nuwa, the mother of all mortals. Of clay she made us, after she made all the animals to fill the world so it would not be empty. And then, when the great monster Gong Gong broke the pillar that held the heavens aloft, it was Nuwa who set it right. When the four directions were scattered, she returned north to north and south the other way where it belongs. Her husband was Fuji, who taught mortals to be civilized and many other useful things.
I love the way he just ends the sentence there. Many other useful things. He doesn't elaborate. He's just like, boomf, done. All right, let's hear what else she has to say. I like listening to storytellers. I like the little spins on each creation myth and so on. It's interesting to hear what they have to say for themselves.
The world is broken again. Will Nuwa come to fix it? Or will some mortal fix it this time? The world is broken again.
Oh, he didn't have much more to say. Hey, pretty. All right, let's sell all our nonsense.
Fine arms, firm armor, fit for the Emperor's guard. See what suits you.
Goodbye to all that. Right.
Fortune.
I think I am most interested in going this way. Oh, I see someone else we can talk to, and a portal.
Ah, warrior, what will become of our world? What will happen to us when the monsters rule it? True, there is the army. At first, they marched in unison against the monsters, but then in the chaos, they were scattered. Harmony and order are broken. Hope is lost. Look around you. This is the Imperial City, where kings once trembled to approach the gates. I ask you, will it ever be rebuilt? I lost my sister, my mother, my father. Would you call me lucky to live in times such as these? Hope? How can we have any hope? More and more monsters come. Who knows how to stop them? No, stranger, I have lost too much to hope. No, stranger, I have...
In a sort of kind of way, I'm glad they didn't turn him into a quest, because they could have easily done that. But they didn't, and that's good. I think... So there's two directions we can go in. Yeah, I'm going to go up this way. And just see what there is to see. Oh, I see. People are murdering me. That's what there is to see. One of these is obviously... one of these parts is going to lead out, and the other one is going to lead to the mausoleum. What I think that we'll do is we will see which one we end at, and then if needs be, I'll just play to get to that point again tomorrow. We're coming up to the end of the stream here soon. And, I don't think it's a good idea to get too involved in anything in particular, if that's the case. But I do want to see... I don't think that we're going to get a level, which is unfortunate. because we've got as many quests as we're likely to get. And these kills aren't going to help us get to the next level. Oh, this is Chang'an Palace. I think I picked the wrong direction. What I really wanted was a mausoleum. Ah, well. We will walk inside. Yeah, this feels like a dungeon. Okay, let's walk the other way. Because I have a feeling that the other way is outward and further. Lucas, good direction. Yeah, well, the thing is, I don't mind getting involved in stuff, but I don't want to do that quite yet. What we'll do tomorrow is we'll maybe peer into the palace and just see what's going on there. Oh, goodness. That's terrible. Oh, good. Everyone's dropping greens. That's also good, and I want to hang on to it, but I'm not going to be able to ever use it, I don't think. Everyone, soak up the soak up the experience shrine. Maybe we can make a level. Right before the stream ends here. I think, let's try and do that at least. Get ourselves a level. Oh, more people to talk to. I really should actually just file this away and know where these people are. Doors. The other thing I wonder, since we're doing all this, is, oh, okay. If, and I don't think this is going to happen this way. These doors are going to stay open. You should get some dex for defensibility ability. Yeah, I probably should. I'm thinking that at about level 30, I'm going to stop swapping. I'm going to stop getting, strength. And I'm going to start picking up intelligence or something. Because I want to be able to wield weapons that let me get a little bit of range. Okay, so it looks like I can go here. Because a little bit of range will probably go a long way.
You cannot open this
door. Oh, okay, I guess not. Okay, well, I don't think we're going to get a level, unfortunately. I don't see folks that we can just kill. So I think, let's look at the map. Yeah, I think that what we're going to do, wait, we can run south, can't we? I'm sure there'll be people there, right? Where's the store that I'm seeing? On my left. How do I get there? I go here. Yeah. Let's, we'll have to kill these guys again, obviously. But I'm okay with that. You should clear palace first. It's a very small area. We'll do that tomorrow. That's literally going to be the first thing we're going to do. I just want to see if maybe in the next couple of minutes here, we can get ourselves a level. And then we're going to end the stream for tonight. Which maybe means I'm going to be a little bit more reckless than I should be. Whoa. Okay. I guess that's where we end the stream. This is a very long loop. Let me go get my experience and kill those guys, and then we'll end the stream. Thank you so much to everyone who has showed up for today. It's been good to play Titan Quest for you. And I'm really enjoying it. It is a fun game. And I'm terrible at it, but that's okay. That's kind of what you're here to watch, I suppose. Let me back away. And at least get one or two of them. And then one or two of them. Okay. That's a little better. Grab that. Okay, I'm going to head back into the city. And we're going to call it a stream there. So almost the first thing that we're going to do tomorrow, this will run up to the palace and see what there is to see in there, because if it's not like a long thing to do, then it should be okay. Yeah, let's wake that one up. Right, thank you so much to everyone who came out for the stream. I really did appreciate it, and I, as I say, enjoyed playing Titan Quest for you. Tomorrow we're going to be doing the same thing, more Titan Quest. We're going to head up this way into the palace there. Mausoleum. Oh, that is the mausoleum. Oh, well, there we go. And then we'll clean it out and then start from there, and we'll go south, because I think south is where we need to be. Have a wonderful evening, and good night for now, folks.